Your rent for your chair and your desk is $5.
I'm gonna be broke.
It is $5. So go ahead and count up your money. $5.
So the foundation of what we're doing in this class is really just having them build confidence with money. So what we do is we just incorporate money within my class. So we pay them for their job and they get to buy things and they get to budget and save money and save for next month or this month. So that's kind of how our class economy started and is still growing and changing and developing even today. I started gradual. I did not start all at once. So how I started within my own classroom is I started with class jobs. At the beginning of the year, we had class jobs, line leader, door holder, teacher helper, eraser, lights person, things of that sort, right? And to reward them for a good job with their class job, I would pay them. So line leader would get $5. A teacher helper would get $10, whatever it may be. And then after I knew that students had at least $15 to $20 within their wallet, I hit them with rent.
I asked how much money always needs to stay in your wallet at all times?
$5.
Why?
Because
Marley, why? Because your rent is $5.
So we had the little conversation of what rent is, how often we pay rent, and how much it is, right? So they had to pay $5 at the beginning of the month. After that, I incorporated a reward list. So we have rewards that they can buy at the end of every 2 weeks when they get paid, ranging in prices from $3, like eating a snack in class when really they're not supposed to $30 where they can be the teacher for the day, right? You can tell the difference within their own ideas about spending money. I have some students that have the bare minimum of like $7, and I have students with $50, right? And they haven't bought rewards in weeks because they want a big reward coming up, or you know, they just are like, I'm okay, I don't need a reward. And that shows different personalities within my classroom as well. Everybody we know spends money differently, so you can see their financial literacy little personalities coming out. Add things slowly. Don't overwhelm them. Don't overwhelm yourself. And really release as much responsibility on the students as possible. Because at this point, my only role in my class economy is putting up a slide for students to pick their jobs. I have a banker. I have people to pass out the wallets. I have, you know, everything is on them. So they're very self-sufficient within their class. And I love watching them blossom and interact with each other. It's amazing. I'm still adding stuff, and it's April, just after spring break, because once I see that my students are confident in one thing, I want to add something else. So I hit them with inflation at the beginning of the year in January, and it was hectic.
Does anybody know what inflation means? Your rent is now $7. Janae, what I will do for you is, because cost of living goes up, unlike what really happens in America, I will also up your pay. You're okay with that? Okay.
I just think that teachers shouldn't count out students of any ages to start learning to be money conscious and to have this financial literacy within the classroom. We may think, oh, they'll learn that in high school, or they'll learn that in college. But if we continue to think that, that student may never learn how to budget. That student may never learn how to save. So I thought it was really important, right, to start now, because they can grasp these concepts. They know what money is. They know how to spend money. It's just the concept of how to do it, what's a healthy and safe way of doing it in a controlled area where there's no real life consequence, right? So rent, we're learning how to pay rent now where, you know, maybe they made a mistake, but they're not getting evicted or getting like a real fine without real life consequences. They're learning it in a safe environment right now.